There was a post on the Entrepreneur subreddit where an entrepreneur wanted to create tutorial videos for their SaaS product and had four requirements. They wanted to see if there was a single tool that could do them all. The first one was they wanted to be able to record themselves and their computer screen at the same time in high quality. The second one was they wanted to be able to edit and trim and polish the video up. The third one was they wanted to be able to create captions for that video. And the fourth one was they wanted to be able to just publish it directly to YouTube. So they weren't sure if a tool like that existed, but it does, and it's called Descript. I've talked about Descript a lot on this channel. If you want a more thorough tutorial, get up and running in 15 minutes, check out this video right here. But in this video, I'm going to specifically run through that four-step process and show how you would easily create a tutorial of your SaaS product or whatever kind of screen share type tutorial you want to make, and how you would upload it to YouTube all in one quick and easy flow. So let's jump into it. All right, so first requirement, let's record video. Inside Descript, we can actually record video. So if we come up here to the little record icon, we can see that it gives us options to record just audio only, record from our camera, or if you're used to Loom, record both your screen and your camera at the same time. So right now I'm on camera mode, and you also get this nice little preview of how your camera looks. And if I click around or click to something else, a little video preview window always stays on top. Now, also, you don't have to start recording or open up the Descript app. The Descript has a little app launcher that comes up here in the top menu bar, so we can just click on this Descript menu bar launcher and instantly load up our camera or screen and camera recording feature. So we can see it switched to my FaceTime camera. Let me switch to the nicer camera. And then if we want something that's a little bit more like Loom, where we have a picture-in-picture effect and I can just scale up my video, we can start recording videos like this anywhere on any program inside any app on our computer. And this is a great way to make tutorials and also showcase you talking so people could see you and see whatever it is that you are trying to explain or teach to them. We can change the format of how this looks, and then we can just stop recording. And because we use this from the Descript app launcher, it sort of either behaves like, hey, maybe we want to just share this link with someone. So we can either copy this over to a new project, we could publish a shareable link, so sort of like you could theoretically use this as a Loom replacement, or we could also just copy this content to our clipboard, and then if I come over to the composition that I already had in Descript and paste it, it automatically pastes the video I just recorded and the text that I just transcribed. Now, if you're working inside a composition, I would say just start recording from inside the composition. It makes things a little easier and automatically adds it inside the document that you are working in. All right, so once we record all of our video, or this process can kind of be done in tandem, we're going to want to edit and trim our clips. So this is gonna get a little bit meta, but this is a video that I did that's also about Descript and then edited in Descript. And now I'm gonna kind of do a breakdown of how we did it inside Descript. So this is a collection of some video recordings from Descript and screen recordings of using Descript and other applications. So you can see this is sort of the finished product where I cut out the parts that I don't want, and check out the full tutorial over how to use Descript and how to work inside the composition. But basically it's like a text document. Let's say I'm playing back the parts, and let's say I want to cut this part out. I can highlight the text, and I can either press delete and just completely remove that, or if I undo that, and if I press Command Delete or this strike through button, it will still act like a cut and delete it, but it will leave the text here. So I like using this a bit more just in case I need to come back, or if someone else is working on the project and doing some of the edits, you can see what text was cut just in case you want to check it and possibly bring it back or use it somewhere else. You can still see that it's not gone. But the use case, they both do the same thing. Striking it out or just deleting it will change your playback. So we go from this point and jump down to here where the strike through text is done. And you can also see down here in the timeline that the audio goes from the moment up here to this cut right here, which is this next clip here. So you're gonna run through your script, polish it up. Also, and this goes into more detail in the other video, but just like a Word document, you can copy or cut and paste text and move clips around if you need to restructure or reorganize things. And it automatically brings the video over. So you don't have to worry about any of that stuff. You just deal with the text files. Okay, so second part, we're gonna trim, clean up our clip. Also, this is where you would add your scenes, which you would also use to add your visuals if you need to add any images or additional video. Again, check out the full tutorial that we have on that. But assuming everything's done, now we're gonna go to step three, which is add captions. So to add captions, let's just say we wanna come to this scene and add captions for this scene. So we're in this scene, scene 9, this is highlighted. We're gonna click the text, click captions, and it adds captions, which is reading the text that we have here. So this would also be a good point where you need to run through this text and clean it up and correct any errors, because whatever text is here is what it's going to display on screen. So we see these captions. If that works for you, cool. Most likely it's going to be too ugly to work for you, so you're going to want to style it up. So if we come over here to the right side, we have our options. So this is the text of our color. We can change the font, change the font size. Let's add a background for this so it's a little bit more legible. Where things get interesting is when we start styling the live text. And the live text is highlighting whatever word is being spoken at that moment. So if we click the little setting icon and we say, okay, we want the active word not to be blue, but let's say we want it to be red. And we want the background to be white. Now when I play this clip back, it automatically highlights and styles the word that is being spoken and the moment. So this is really good for keeping attention, really good for keeping focus. And we could also change the styling of future words. Let's say we don't want them to be as bright, so they're a little dim until they're spoken. So other thing, let's say we want the text box to display two lines and not just one line. If we reduce our font size a bit and then click and drag this text box and get on a line that has actually more text, then we can see we can adjust it and we can get two lines. You can mess around with the settings a bit. You can squeeze as many lines as you want, but basically the more you reduce the width, then it will add more line breaks to fit that on screen. And same thing if you want that style, we're just showing like one word at a time really quickly, which is usually more useful for like a TikTok or social media clip. If you just make the box way smaller so it can't display more, then it will display one or two words at a time very quickly. So you can mess around, style that however you like. If you're doing this for more of a YouTube video, then I would keep this as more traditional captions that are a little less distracting. Now, the other thing too is that this is captions in the sense that it is captions burnt into the video. It is part of the video files. Wherever you upload it, the captions will be on the video. But what you might want, and is usually a better case, is you want to upload subtitle files to YouTube, which supports subtitle files. So you don't actually want the text burnt into the video. You want the video to not have the captions, but you want to export this text and send it as a caption file, which is known as an SRT file, to YouTube. And so to do that, if you come over here to publish, and you say export, and then you select subtitles, you can export the SRT file, and that will just take whatever text is here, export it with the proper encoding that says, hey, at this time, it's gonna say this word, and then at this time, it's gonna say this word. And so that's an industry standard format where pretty much any video editor, Vimeo, Wistia, YouTube, they will all support SRT files. So we're gonna go to our fourth step, which is publish to YouTube. And so we could do that straight from Descript. You don't even have to export the video file. If you want to export the video file, you go to export video file, choose your settings, but we can just go to publish, click down this link, and then go to YouTube. And we can add our title here. We can adjust our description. If you added markers in your script, it will automatically add the time code of those markers in the description, which is useful as that's how you add the little chapter markers inside your YouTube video so people can click around and navigate your video more easily. You can adjust your category, you can add tags here, and you can change the privacy settings. I would keep it to private so it uploads to YouTube, and then you go to your YouTube studio and change your thumbnail, fine tune your settings so it's not live yet, and then push it live on YouTube. But if you really didn't want to deal with that, you could change your settings and set it live immediately from here. And then you would just sign in, authenticate your account, and push it directly from Descript to YouTube. And now with this YouTube integration, it doesn't actually export the captions. So you would need to go export the SRT file, save that. And then when you go to YouTube, you go to the captions and you upload that SRT file. And that's it. Four quick steps. You can do it all in Descript. I hope you found this tutorial useful. Let me know what you thought down in the comments below. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button for more videos and tutorials like this. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you in the next episode.